what is the definition of being rich? The definition of being rich, or the meaning of being rich according to the world, is when people have a lot of money, when they have a big luxurious house and a trendy car, and even people want their own farmhouse and a ranch with horses. All these things, because these are the desires of the young generation today, because of their exposure on social media, where they watch all these people in the entertainment field and all that, living a luxurious life. But with all that's happening around, we can see how the downhill of it also. When they have a lot of money, what happens, and how drugs come into their life, and how they lose their peace, and how they end up in jail. Okay, let's not talk about it. But the Bible says in 1 Timothy chapter 6 verse 17, the Bible says, God richly supplies us with all things to enjoy. And there's one particular girl who said, I got two jobs, So I was wondering, you got two jobs? I mean, how does one get two jobs? How do you get to work in two places? I mean, if you are working on an hour basis, like in America, where they pay you on hour basis, okay, 1 hour, 2 hours or whatever. And so that way you can do some shifts like this, one or two shifts. But you cannot when you cannot have an appointment letter with one particular organization, where you are supposed to, give your full time to them, and then you go and work outside, is not a righteous way. That's not the right thing to do. There are some people who do some work during the lunch break for some paperwork they do. For very, very, cunningly they do all that. This is all kind of, this is all, you can put it into that folder of theft. You're stealing the time from the organization that you're working for. These are all unrighteous ways. So why do they want like that? I mean, when you're going to work from 9 to 5 somewhere, and from 5 to 7 somewhere, where do you have time for God, people? Please understand, being rich, the Bible says in John 10:10, God says that I have come to give you life in abundance. Satan comes to steal, kill and destroy. Yes, he is coming to steal, kill and destroy your peace, your joy and everything, by capturing your attention and distracting your attention into other ways. So people, what they do, they want to work from morning till evening, morning till night sometimes, and then the whole night play video games. I believe what they say, that they want to release their stress. In order for them to release their stress, they go watch a movie, or they watch a video. But then where's God in your life? Where's God in your life? And how can you have a peace in abundance, a life in abundance, when you do like that? I saw something really beautiful in the next scripture. The same 1 Timothy chapter 6 verse 18, the Bible says that you have to be rich in good works. Oh God, that's too beautiful. Find time to go and find time in your life to go and spend time with poor children, play cricket with them. You know how happy God will be. You know what God said? When you do that, you're doing it for me. When you do something for these little ones, you're doing it for me. When you go to an orphanage, or when you take some poor children along with you in the car and take them to a park, amusement park. I mean, your life is very selfish, just revolving around you, your family and all that. But God is telling, just come out of that border and do good works. Do good works. Teach some people English. Teach some language. Do something. That is an abundant life. In Acts 21, we read about a man, Philip. Awesome, awesome, awesome. He's got four daughters, and the Bible says all his four daughters, they prophesy. Amen. And you know what? Their house becomes a real guest house for Paul and his team. Imagine serving an apostle like Paul and his team. It's a tough job. I know, having such servants of God in your house, but Philip's house was like that. That is an abundant life. I'm going to just post some more on YouTube. So you click on YouTube and watch the complete message. God bless you.